More than $500 million has been committed to keeping Kiwis safe from crime with a raft of new measures revealed in a pre-budget announcement. The goal is to have at least one police officer for every 480 people in the country. Gangs are also being targeted, with $94 million going towards tackling organised crime. And after a spate of recent ram raids, there's funding to help businesses protect themselves against these sorts of attacks. Senior political reporter Benedict Collins has details and reaction.
This Mangere petrol station, the latest site of a late-night ram raid. The attack coming as no surprise to a retailer across the road.
It's happened three times now. That's what we have heard, and which is not appreciated because everybody's working hard.
And it's the spike in high-octane crimes like these that has the government worried.
It's dreadful, isn't it? That's why we're acting so quickly to ensure that we can work with small businesses to deal with the issue of ram raids.
How exactly they will combat ram raids isn't clear.
We've got a little bit more work to do, particularly in consulting small businesses.
Let's stop the ram raids. Let's actually stop them happening so they don't have to put bollards in, so they don't have to take more and more extreme measures in terms of trying to fortify their shops. We live in New Zealand. We should be the most peaceful and the safest country in the world, and we're not.
Concerns too that police are increasingly having guns turned on them, so nearly $300 million for tactical training and targeting gangs.
Given the community concern that many groups have been creating recently, they're going to feel a fair bit of the brunt of this focus.
This criminologist, highly supportive of a boost in funding for women's prisons.
I like the idea that we look at women in prison because it allows us to look at the drivers of crime a bit more, far more than we do with the men.
Meanwhile, in Tauranga this morning, residents were woken by the sound of the stolen car crashing, then bursting into flames.
Damaged the neighbour's car. The police came and they took off on foot and they had the dogs out.
Police caught two occupants trying to flee, a 15-year-old charged with breaching bail, a plea today to keep youth crime in perspective.
We've got to realise that this is a spike, it's not a trend. In terms of youth offending, it's actually decreased over the last few years.
A promise today too for more new cops.
We want to make sure that we have enough police to do the fantastic job that they do to keep our community safe.
The government hoping this response to the crime spikes achieves that.
Benedict's with us. Kia ora, Benedict. The government's pitching this announcement today as a good news story. What's your take on that?
Well, there's only one way to describe today's announcement, and that is damage control. The government had been intending to make this law and order announcement on Budget Day in a couple of weeks' time, but because of this huge attention that these crimes like ram raids are getting, they've been forced to bring that forward to today. Now, the problem for the government is they've got the National Party there banging that softened crime drum again and again, and they're really worried that that is starting to take hold with the public. Compounding the problems for the government here is they've got a police minister who at times really looks like she's on the ropes in her portfolio. So the government will be hoping that this announcement today really changes the sort of dial on this.
And while we've got you, Benedict, the Prime Minister has been forced into isolation. What more can you tell us about that?
Yeah, that's right. Not a great start to our Mother's Day for the Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern this morning. Her partner, Clark Gayford, woke up this morning not feeling particularly well. He took a test and tested positive for COVID-19, which means that the Prime Minister and her family are in isolation for the next week. And now Jacinda Ardern said both she and her daughter, Niamh, are both feeling fine, and she promised to keep working remotely throughout the week.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks, Benedict.